Is Esther, and you're welcome to your home of purest of entertainment, reality show reviews, and what have you. Please do it to subscribe and welcome to family once again. We love you. So this particular story, anyway, let's just start. So there's a particular deal, an endorsement deal that has been causing drama. It was announced even till now, my people, especially from a lot of people. They were kind of disappointed for doing what they think she did. They called her names and so many unimaginable things. So they were disappointed that Liquor Rose wasn't really signed to a known skin care brand. The usual Baby Naija ones. There are some general accepted brands in Baby Naija as far as endorsements and deals is concerned, that when your fave is signed to them like this, automatically fans believe that you are cashing out big. Forgetting that most of this brand were nobody, like we did not even know them until they first signed their Baby Naija first ambassador. For instance, now, we didn't really know Get Fit until Tacha came on board. We didn't know Jenny's Glow until Ozo and Nengi came on board. I can't forget that Abuja shut down, the both of them did last year. We didn't really get to know about Speedy Weight Loss until Ozo and other people came on board. So you see, I'm wondering, why are people giving themselves headache over all of this? All of that brand that they are eyeing did not start today. Now, all of this drama continued small until Emmanuel now also announced and that he was signed to the same deal few days later. Hey, woo, guys, come and see wala that started from that time till now. They still show her. Since as I'm even doing the story, the whole thing has increased like times 10. Like, they have been abusing the chorus with this decision, abusing her even as we speak. They were like, you mean this girl accepted a brand that is not known, according to them, just so she can be doing couple goals, that she rejected real money just because of one nonsense relationship or more. Come and see name calling our own fans, like correct bashing for accepting the same deal as Emmanuel. So you guys prepare just in case they sign another deal together. That is why I'm giving you guys heads up now, right now. Like, they said she's a fool. Hey Lord, come and see name that they call. In their words, they said Liquor Rose really refused a better skincare deal in tens of million. I wonder how they know about that. Is it by popularity? I beg. They said because she wanted to do couple goals with Rizari for peanuts. Such a dumb fool, Beatrice called her. Wow. This one shocked me when I saw. Now, this has been some people's opinion and thoughts. They were really expecting her to get signed to those normal Baby Naija skin care brand, those popular ones that we all know. Then I've been asking myself, for how long will this continue? They always have one thing or the other to say, no matter the deal, no matter whatever she signs, no matter even any of those housemates. Some of the things I found out, so that you guys can leave this girl alone and stop criticizing her, because I know this will still even happen again, and it's still even happening to now. So yeah, some of the things I found out, against whatever assumptions some people might be having, that I think made her accept the deal. So come along. Way before she went to the house, way before she went to the house, a TikTok video and everything, she was always influencing, doing videos for them. That was like a brand way before she went to the house. And guys, not crying out, those people even posted her on their official page to campaign for her when she was in the house. Like, can you imagine such loyalty and love? Even now, me self, I would love to continue with them, because these ones are not colleagues anymore. They're not just brands that I work with. They're like family already. Like, they campaign for her back to back. Like, this means the owner must have been a very good person to her, and vice versa, for the chorus to have decided to continue a work relationship they had even before the house. Like, they definitely have a good relationship, which is so obvious. And the fact that she has maintained same skin brand, it's just loyalty for me. Now thinking about this, I think this is what Get Fit will have also enjoyed. She also influenced for them before going to the house now, if not that they decide to play a fast one and didn't turn out well. Like, it's still, they pay me for those ones, yeah. So I think this is like the major reason. Those people are more than just brand for her. They're like family already. So for me, I think that is why she accepted the brand, far beyond, way beyond what others are thinking that she collected because of Emmanuel. No, Likuru's understand the assignment. Like, I love how she talked about her skin breaking out when she got to the Bibi Naija house and how the product is working for her now. Not crowning all guys, she was the creative director. Ah, God, almost see talent. Oh, boy. Like, what day of the week did God create Likuru's with plenty talent like this? This is nice. So, please, she signed same deal with Emmanuel for couple go. She's blah, 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 blah. Should not even be a discussion at all. She had a relationship with them, which they remained loyal to even when she was in the house. And she just felt she should continue with it. I do not see anything bad with her, guys. So she's a very loyal person, and that you can never take away from her. Proud? You can never force her to stop rolling with people she has been rolling with. She is a very loyal person. We all know that about. Anyway, it's all good. And then Emmanuel's advert also turned out beautiful concept. I mean, shippers now only waiting for their joint advert together. But if they now do the advert together or pictures together, those criticizing her for collecting the deal because of Emmanuel, I see you go too full that day, Sha. You go too full. Some people criticizing her for accepting it for couple goals. You go too full. Almost, I shall the way Sha see house. Now, moving on to what I've been talking about, Beatrice. Yeah, Beatrice has also been doing so well for herself. Like, I'm legit proud and happy for that girl. Like, her progress, I love it. I won't lie. Though, for someone who left that early and is doing this great for herself, no, she's doing so well. Like, gotten some influencing gigs so far, bought a car, was on the cover of a magazine. I am so happy and proud of her. No cap, like, more wins for you, baby. But while we were celebrating this, it's how Angel came out and dropped a bomb. Reading it word for word, I didn't really read meaning to it until I started seeing people's posts and comment. All the girlies are buying themselves cars, and I love that for them, to be honest. Nothing better than women in their own rights. I actually did not see anything wrong with this one. Then as I seen husband snatcher cannot relate, Maria left the group chat, and Street Bullet don't go eat Kelvin Saichi for a bend. Oh god. Not some girls driving married men cars for good 5 years. No be juju be did. Someone should come and catch her sobo and everything. Side end cannot relate. And if not Kubana and Just Lover, Miss Whatever will still be using Kevin's ride to be fooling herself. Wanna be. Why are people like this always speaking for Wala where there is none? Why are you guys like this? Must it always be violence? For me, I didn't see anything there. I felt she was just proud and happy for the girls, for the ladies. I think Maria should also have her own car, so that she's not putting out there doesn't mean she probably does. And even if she doesn't, I don't think whatever Angel wrote is for anybody. She's just appreciating the fact that the ladies are doing so well. I think that's what she meant. But if you think otherwise, let me know at the comment section. Finally, Perry wraps up on TMC. Yeah, so you guys remember that that made a lot of people question if the producers and directors made the right decision replacing the former Aminu with Perry. Well, Perry went against all odds, gave it all a shot, and it's a wrap on the set already, guys. I can't wait for it to be out. I am so sure he killed it. And it's only a matter of time people will get to accept him and his new role and get used to him the way they were used to the former Aminu. I think it will get better when it drops. And then he'll be able to, I'm sure he'll be able to convince them and win their hearts over. I think it will. Anyway, well done and thumbs up, Perry. I can't wait for the series to finally drop to see what you cooked. I'm sure you killed it as usual. So guys, that's all I have for you in this video.